In congestion collapse, an increase in traffic load suddenly results in a decrease of useful work done. As we can see here, up to a point, as we increase network load, there is an increase in useful work done. At some point, the network reaches saturation, at which point increasing the load no longer results in useful work getting done. But at some point, actually increasing the traffic load can cause the amount of work done or the amount of traffic forwarded to actually decrease. There are many possible causes. One possible cause is the spurious retransmissions of packets that are still in flight. So when senders don't receive acknowledgments for packets in a timely fashion, they can spuriously retransmit, thus resulting in many copies of the same packets being outstanding in the network at any one time. Another cause of congestion collapse is simply undelivered packets, where packets consume resources and are dropped elsewhere in the network. The solution to spurious retransmissions is to have better timers and to use TCP congestion control, which we'll talk about next. The solution to undelivered packets is to apply congestion control to all traffic. Congestion control is the topic of the rest of this lesson.